got another seven gamer in prospect here. Don't rule it out.
How could we not?
Early cider of Aruna's prime method of attack. Huge cut on the forehand, first point.
1-0.
Got an opportunity to watch Aruna play the countryman of Morgard in the round of 16, that Christian Carlson. You had two big men just swiping at it and big heavy hitting. And we'll see if we're going to get that with Truls Morgard as well, whether he'll stand toe to toe with Quadri Aruna.
2-1.
I guess he will.
1-3.
In terms of the equipment, of course, the racket of Morgard and the roulette here, and the colourful rubber, of course, now permitted. The ITTF rules changing to allow Aruna. Of course, we've gone from the red and black choice.
I think Aruna last night in his interview post-match against Christian Carlson said that was in honor of the Nigerian flag, the green they have there. I called it electric greens, but I'll go with the flag green. It's a better description.
4-5.
Nice touch on the serve by Aruna. You think of him as a big power hitter, and yet he makes a play off that on the serve. One thing I'll note last night, Guy, that was evident after the match is how many fans the Quadri Aruna has here in Houston, Texas, supporting his run towards a medal at the World Table Tennis Championships.
That's the price on offer here as well. Reaching the semis, and guarantee a medal. And he's so popular wherever he goes, Aruna has been such an important figure for development of the sport in his own country. Massive in terms of his social media following, the way he plays.
Let 7-5.
He's obviously a big man, but he gets around really well too. Tremendous footwork, extremely quick for a big guy.
7-6.
As well, picking up fans for fun this week.
7-6.
The Swedes just keep developing good talent after good talent.
For sure.
7-0.
That's clever from Morgard. Excellent feeling on the forehand. All in play, just teasing Aruna again to go for a bit more.
8-7.
It was a good decision. It looked like Aruna was committed to the left side of the table. I think that even had that hit square on top, Aruna was going to have a difficult time getting to it.
come through, as he said in his previous rounds in his career. That forehand is going to have to keep delivering again and again. It's ferocious.
Dance with who brung you, as they say. That's his game. Why go any other direction? Although we've seen a little touch out of him already in this match. If he gets the big swing, he's going to take it. And if he hits it, you're going to have trouble getting it back.
Oh God, facing down two game points.
Good example of how well Aruna can get around the court, but couldn't quite get back quick enough on the back end.
Immaculate in his third ball attack there. What a sweep. So, it's tight here. Didn't just expect that with their runs through that they would come out the gates.
Well, there's no way we're not going seven games, guy. Come on. We might just well go to the seventh game right now.
Third game point opportunity here for the Nigerian. For Aruna. Morgard now with a game point. Oh! And he converts, and there's that familiar reaction.
Last one.
With a little chop block, I think. Keep himself in the point. This was after the initial chop block, as Aruna looked to press there on the Swede.
2-1.
Up the line there. Such watchable game styles as well. You can tell they've got a packed house here. They're responding to that quality of points, the entertaining nature of the points being produced.
Saturday night table tennis in Houston, Texas, international style. That edge has been awful helpful to both players now.
Yeah, wry smile from Morgard there. Made his point that went against him. They take risk, the both of them. Maverick qualities about the way they approach the sport.
Good example of it right there. Big swing off the serve by Morgard, paid off. Kid does not look unfazed under the bright lights right now.
Oh. 6-3.
Even with his power, difficult for Aruna back from there. Some great work on that ball as well, around the outside of it, Morgard.
4-6.
Hitting the body, knocked the wind out of Morgard with that shot.
Four, six. 5-6.
space on this attack from Aruna. Oh, he loads up. Has a lead of two at the latest towel break. Sure, we've actually discussed the head-to-head. There's one meeting, but it's actually really relevant, Mark, here, because happened, of course, back in August, the World Table Tennis Budapest contender. Quarterfinals, Morgaard won in a fifth and deciding game.
Had to go to a five games. It was a five-game match. Had to go the distance, I guess is the best way to say it. I think against these two guys.
Yeah.
That's what we're looking at.
That's the thing here. They're evenly matched because they do different things well. Morgaard, of course, beating Aruna on the way to the title that weekend in Hungary. Big title success for him.
Morgaard takes another one in the body there from Aruna. It's going to be black and blue at the end of this thing.
Nicknamed, of course, Aruna Balboa. My supporters.
8-7.
Looking to bludgeon his way back into this. There's one of his own from Morgaard.
Second time this game that we've seen that serve to the forehand side where Morgaard said, you know what? That's on a tee right now. I'm going to hit that one right down the middle of the fairway.
Again here at the back end of the game. Remember, Aruna had three game points, was in this position first and couldn't win the opener. Third towel break of the game, and Morgaard here looking very good for a two game advantage. He needs the one. Raised fist. A poignant year, of course, for the sport.
One love.
Love two. Think about Aruna is here. Two down. Okay, he's lost the second there, had game points. So Philly probably should be one each on balance here. But the way he plays, there won't be any change.
I wouldn't expect. He knows his game, and there's no point in trying to hide it. This is my game, and I'm going to come with it. And if he's on his game, he's tough to beat. Morgaard, I think, has done a good job of mixing things up to this point.
I think spot on, Mark. And the thing is with Aruna as well is while he back himself here, I think he should be one each, but he's two down. I think, I've got time, and we know with this guy that when he catches fire, can be unplayable for periods.
And he is hot and alive here in game three.
And he quickly reel through a game, two games. Just go on a hot streak, such is the manner, the style of play.
Last six.
I mean, I remember actually with Aruna going to the first towel break here, he hasn't lost a point yet in this third game. I remember commentating him in the Rio Olympics. I mean, the run he put together. You know, Chuan Chi Yuan, Timo Boll, dispatched. Run through to the quarters. And just go through periods where he is unplayable.
Last seven.
And when you're a player like that, you wait for that moment. You wait for all of a sudden when it comes alive in your body. You kind of fight through the difficult moments. And there's a great example of it. What a brilliant shot by Quadri Aruna of Nigeria.
It just kept going and going.
Let eight loft. Nine loft.
Is he going to offer up a mercy point here? Oh, well, he doesn't have to because Morgaard. This is exhibition stuff from these two. Morgan reminding us here in this game he's still here.
I love Morgan's body language after that hot hit. Like, finally.
110.
The game is almost done, though. Aruna here. Game points.
10-2.
It's been free swinging here from the very first point. It's all done there. Morgan will look to reset. You know what I've loved, Mark, about this quarterfinal so far is there is no indication here. The two of them, they've come out, the big introductions, they're not playing any differently.
Than if they're in training,
they're in the practice hall. I mean, just, this is a world championship quarterfinal.
It's a great point. I don't see any nervousness at all, any tentative play at all from either of these guys. Love it, and I know the crowd's loving it too.
Love three.
Counter. What a counter from Morgan.
Morgan trying to return the favor of the big run in game three by Aruna.
Five block.
Towel break, and Morgan doing to Aruna what he did to him in the previous game, getting there without losing a point.
That's a good example, though, of what you were talking about, Guy. I mean, you're down 5-0. You think, okay, I'm just going to tap this, get it back on the table. Yeah. So he takes a big swing and ends up in the net.
No compromise there. As we referenced earlier, Aruna, his best chance of victory is to play his way, all out attack.
7-2.
That's how he's made his big splash on the big stages, is to be who he is. And I would recommend that to anybody. Be who you are.
Side. We've seen this already. We've seen some terrific backhands in the event this week. The men's draw, he's got another one.
The Swedish Federation has to be looking at this kid saying, thank you. We need this. Got to keep the pipeline going.
8-4.
No, well, they have done for a while. I go back to being at the World Team Championships in Halmstad. Morgan at home. Back in 2018, and he's 16 years of age at that point, and he was involved in the team. They were looking to bring him through. Spotted something very early on, the ability of this young man.
It kind of reminds me of the confidence that they have in Anton Shellberg as well. He's a younger guy, and they're putting him on the big stage in big moments because they have confidence for the future. Why not on this kid?
We've seen it this week time and again. 6 game points now for Morgan to restore the 2-game cushion. Backhand working a treat. Who would have thought that at the beginning of the week? But it's been a week of surprises. What's Aruna got at this stage? Remember, he was 2 down in that quarterfinal in Budapest. With all respect to that tournament, it's not the World Championships, but he was 2 down there and came back to force a fifth. Do not rule this Nigerian standout out of the picture at this stage. Perfectly capable of going on a tear.
When you talk about confidence, I look at Aruna and you can just see it exuding from his pores. This is a gentleman that's got no fear whatsoever.
Flailing at thin air there, though.
One, two.
Clearly on the defensive on that point. Yeah, that ball's probably dented right there. You might want to just take that one out of play.
Really. Here's another favor of Aruna this time.
And as a player, I see this in table tennis. How do you stop the streak? What's the answer? I mean, one of the things you see is start spinning the ball. Don't give him anything flat, anything that he's able to just tee off on. Oh, what a backhand!
That is a counter. Aruna lighting it up here in Houston. Teasing Morgaard, and then out of nowhere. Really.
No one's running that one down. Except maybe a mile long.
4-6.
This is what I do.
7-5.
Great save off the table that time by Aruna, but unfazed. Morgaard stuck with it.
Leaning into that one and still right in touch here. Of course, Morgaard, if he wins this game, be through to the final four. Real deception in the touch there.
Tremendous touch, tremendous moment to do it.
Set, 9-7.
Fabulous again from these two. They continue to embrace the occasion.
Morgaard took a bigger swing with every ball.
Nine,
Swede here at the fertile break. And he, dangerous to think ahead, but he's so close here to the semi-final. He's been playing catch up throughout this particular game, the fifth one. Now 2 points from victory with the service. Maruna says, not so fast. I want to play longer.
Didn't see a whole lot of nervousness there from Maruna on that play.
By Morgan. So clear point winning margin needed here. Serve rotating. Timely for Morgan, far less so for Aruna. First match point for the 19-year-old.
I love it.
Match point down, Mark. And there's no compromise.
Swing for the fences, you know?
He knows no other way.
12-11.
Second match point for Morgard. You're kidding me. Absolutely kidding me. Match point down. And Aruna comes up with that.
I love his reaction too. Like, yep, he's waiting on that.
Again, yeah, come in with a little push receive there. Start the point now. Now up the line as well. Aruna with designs on taking this further. Second game point for the Nigerian now.
And he's got it.
He has. He saved 2 match points there, Aruna. Six beginning here of this quarterfinal. If you're just joining us, I don't know where you've been. You've missed quite a lot already here.
But you probably have some more to go, because we're not letting them go without 7 games here.
So Morgard has recently had 2 match points to reach the semi-finals. Aruna saving them both to keep this alive, take it into a 6th. Really good. Would he have been thinking on any of those match points at the semi-finals? He thinks back to their one previous meeting where he was 2 up on Aruna. Just needs to look at the runs that they've put together this week. Both of them in the face of adversity, how they've shone. Well, with Aruna, say with Morgard as well, if he was behind, he's shown it as well. But Aruna has that ability, that maverick quality to come back into matches like this. I mean, look at how he played the second match point.
I've seen nothing but absolute confidence in his eyes, even when his back was to the wall twice. On what, you know, in a way, I would imagine, I know he had a great run at the Olympics, but in a certain way, this is maybe the opportunity of a lifetime. He's 33 years of age.
And remember, this is the chance to secure not just a semi-final place, but a world championship singles medal at the very, very least. That's what's on the line here. It's all the more remarkable that these two can play at this level and play so freely.
It's a real credit to the two athletes, I have to say. Because how many times do we see the big game, people don't live up to it? I think both of these gentlemen are doing that.
down at the table by Rachel Ramos, our assistant umpire. It's pretty sweaty work out there under the lights.
A lot of people in this building right now, a lot of body heat.
Pinned Aruna down. I mean, Aruna was actually happy going from the backhand corner, but Morgaard eventually able to work the opening.
Great body lean that time by Morgaard, leaning right into that block. Five in a row. Off the paddle of the young Swede. Oh, that stops that.
7-6.
It's terrific.
Crowd on hand tonight, guy. Absolutely love it.
I mean, I was just thinking the same thing here. I was excited coming here. I think everyone, the first time these world championships coming to the USA, to the States, and it's just lived up. It's so good having these crowds here, the atmosphere.
Let 7-8.
Thank all the people in Houston who have been so cooperative.
9-7.
Players here have appreciated that as well. And you talk about the manner of the performance. It's inspired by the crowd, by the noise and everything, taking them to new levels.
Let 9-7.
Yeah, deep breath here for Morgaard, 2 points away.
10-7.
Now he's again at match points. He had two, remember, in the previous game. So he would not be, should not be getting ahead of himself here. Three more match points for the Swede.
Oh, what a point to end it on.
The teenage dream continuing here in Houston for Truls Morgaard.